Hi students, so coming for today's video, we are going to see the exercise 2 with a small adjustment of bank loan repaid under the payment side which is given for the current year. How we are going to take this? So this is only small change, so all the rest part will be the same. So as this picture of question is not clear, I have just made the page break. So let us see how the small changes are going to be observed by us and taken up to make our calculations very simple. Just observe, I have made the opening balance sheet as a division for you people to just observe, first concentrating on the outstandings. So we need to concentrate on outstandings and market year. Only outstanding office expenses on the liability part is what we found. And could you all find your, I have ignored it, I have striken out the value of that. Why we have done this? Because if this opening, the last year, is considered or accounted into the present years under the payment side as we did yesterday's video or the previous video, we are going to just strike it off. So we are not going to concentrate on this anymore. So all the rest part of the items are only related to the new balance sheet. So when we are preparing balance sheet, let us concentrate on the all other items. Now this is the first part which we have done. We are going to be free enough not concentrating on the opening balance sheet. Now moving on to the next, receipts and payments account. This is the next part which we need to concentrate. Now as I have done here certain small changes, just observe office expenses on the payment side. 16 and 17 is the opening, so I have striked it out. So once when we are ignoring it, we need not concentrate on that. For the current year, 17 and 18, 17,000 is to be considered. Apart from that, what are the items which you need to concentrate on? Could you all find here? I have just marked a star and underlined with bank loan repaid. So the word bank loan repaid is not an expenses for us. It's only repaid. The loan is repaid. The loan cannot be treated as a day-to-day expenses. So concentrating on this item we are going to ignore in case of expenditure. This is directly going to be taken under the liability when we are preparing the new balance sheet. So all the rest part will be just the same. Now we are going to just observe how we are going to do. Apart from that, concentrate on the next adjustment part. Now we wanted the items related to income and expenditure. So first let us concentrate on the income and expenditure items, and later let us concentrate on the balance sheet items that is going to affect. Now going for the adjustment, could you observe the first item is what I have underlined. So this is what we need to concentrate: subscription outstanding for the current year, then salary prepaid, for prepaid in the sense paid in advance for the next year. So they have paid in advance. So these two items we need to concentrate when we are going to go for income and expenditure. All the rest will be same as we have done in the previous video. So now let us just go for the sum that actually is required for us to concentrate on. Just observe here, I have I have just prepared the income and expenditure account as instructed. As instructed, they have asked us just observe. Prepare income and expenditure account for the year ending 31st March 2018. So I've just concentrated on this. So moving on to your income and expenditure account, just concentrate on this and observe towards your income side. I've just done it because all the steps are same as previous, only a small change required that was going to be highlighted. Let us concentrate on what is required. Moving on for the income side, we are going to concentrate first on the income side. So from the opening balance sheet, as I said, there is nothing to be concentrated on. So I'm just going to take up the items which comes under receipt side. Now just observe receipt side. So using these two, so we are going to concentrate only receipts and income side. Now moving on to the receipt side, could you all find a subscription for the current year given as 45,000? So I've taken this in the inner column because we have current year outstanding of 5,000, so that is going to be added. So apart from this, nothing else is there. The next year received in advance will be in the liability side, which I have marked here as L. So this is going to be in the liability. Then moving on to the next item, just observe the receipt side and the income side, how the steps are done. Next, entrance fees. Going to the entrance fees immediately, I said concentrate on the instruction under the adjustment. So here they have given, we need to capitalize 50%, half of the entrance fees as a liability capitalize, and remaining to be treated as income, and donation 100% is going to be a liability, which means capitalize, it should be capitalized. So entrance fees, concentrating towards your income side, 50% have taken out of 8,000, 4,000 is treated as income. Next, apart from entrance fees, we have donations, that is completely to be capitalized, so I've marked as L. Next, interest is the only receipt, so there is no adjustment for interest, so I've just taken it directly to the outer column. So we have completed income side only. We have three items here, so it's 59,000 as a total on the income side, which I got. Next, moving on to your expenditure side. Now we need to concentrate towards your expenditure side and how we are going to do this. So moving on to your expenditure side. Now just observe the expenditure side and the payment side. Payment and expenditure. Now, payment side, first we have office expenses. Office expenses, the current year we are going to take 17,000 directly. There is no outstanding for the current year, and the last year has already been accounted. So only the present 17,000 we are going to take up. I have taken. Next, printing and postage expenses is going to be your. So I have written here as stationery. It's going to be postage. So let me correct it. So printing and postage expenses is 600. Next, we have salary given in the question. So salary I've taken as adjustment is there. I've taken in the inner column 25,000. Look at the adjustment. Moving on to your adjustment. Observe the adjustment. Towards your adjustment, could you all find your salary prepaid 2500? So So when it is prepaid, it is paid in advance, we should minus. If it is outstanding, we should add. If it is paid in advance, we should minus for the exact value that we need. So I get 22,500, the exact value for the current year salary paid. Then moving on to the next item after salary. Purchase of books is an asset. So that is balance sheet. Bank loan repaid. It's not expenditure. It's a balance sheet. Then subscription to newspaper. It is an expenditure. So I've taken that. No adjustment. Take it directly to the outer column. Then moving on to the next adjustment side. After completing this part, we need to concentrate on the next step of adjustment. Subscription outstanding is taken. Salary prepaid is taken. Capitalized entrance fees is done. Donations we should see in the balance sheet. And the last adjustment left out. Always have a glance once. Depreciate buildings by 10% per annum. So this we need to take up. So I've done here. 70,000 is going to be your buildings value. So 70,000 is only on the building. So 70,000 I have taken it in the next under the bracket and calculated with 10%. So I get 7,000 as a value. So we have done the part of income and expenditure now. Just moving on to your income and expenditure account. Observe your which is needed to be concentrated now. Credit side is what greater for us. 59,000. And just observe. Credit side is what is needed to be observed by us. Now I get 59,000 credit side greater. So from 59,000, I'm going to reduce each and every value as similarly. So we get surplus as 11,300. That is just matching for the answer which we have found in the question. 11,300. Just observe your surplus 11,300. I got the same as 11,300, the surplus. So the main part here which we need to concentrate is only the bank loan repaid. How we are going to concentrate on this? Now we have done, so let us move on for the balance sheet items. Now coming for the balance sheet, concentrate on the balance sheet, how the items are, that is one small different items are going to be taken up by us and that is going to be highlighted here. So let us just concentrate first on the assets that I've just done it. So let me explain you people how we need to just do it in an easy and a simple manner. Going to the first, as I said, opening balance sheet is only related for the new balance sheet to be prepared. So concentrating on this first, cash in hand. Cash in hand, we need to take the current year's closing balance. What is the balancing figure from the receipts on payment side? Always just observe, this is going to be the one which we need to take. 26,800, I have taken that. Then moving on to the next asset, furniture, no adjustment, take it directly, I have taken it. Buildings, that is adjustment, so I've taken in the inner column. We have depreciation which we calculated 7,000 here under the expenditure side, so I've taken that. So after the deduction of this, I get 63,000. Then sports material from the question, 20,000, no adjustment, take it directly in the outer column. Then library books, 30,000, I have taken it in the inner column. And there is an addition purchase of books which is under the payment side. So this has to be added along with the library books. So I've added it, purchase of books. So I get 40,000 in the outer column. Then, so now just observe, payment side we have completed and the opening balance sheet items are also being taken. Now concentrating on your adjustment side, incomes outstanding, subscription outstanding, I have taken on the asset side. Then salary prepaid, any expenses paid in advance, asset side. So I've taken it directly to the outer column. So my asset side is completed. Now moving on to your liability part. Again, from the opening, so we have two items. First, let me concentrate on capital fund of the current years, how we are going to complete it with. So 120,000 is the opening balance. So I've just taken up the opening balance is 120,000. Then concentrating to your receipts and payment side, go for the receipts. Liability always receipt. Donation is the thing that need to be concentrated on. Just observe donations. Donations 12,000. So I have taken here 12,000 of donation in the inner column completely, fully to be capitalized. And entrance fees, half was under income and remaining half is to be capitalized. So 4,000 similarly, 50% I have taken under capital fund. Then apart from this, we have the surplus which we received as 11,300. So that is going to be added. So after adding all these, I get capital fund as 147,300. Just observe opening balance, donation, entrance fees and surplus. See, all these are related to the trust. Clear? So this is the only value we need to observe and assume and take it as a capital fund items. Bank loan is not treated because this is the money from the outsiders, which is not going to be permanent. Capital fund is permanent. Clear? Okay, next. Going for the next part. So we have completed from this donation entrance fees. Apart from this, we have the other part which need to be concentrated. Subscription we have for 18 and 19 received in advance for the next year. Any income received in advance treated as a liability. So I've taken it on the liability part and have just highlighted with a color for this and taken it directly to the outer column, the value of 5,000. Next, concentrating towards your opening balance, again the left part, bank loan. This is to be considered as a separate value. So I have done apart from all the items. Now finally, bank loan inner column, 35,000. And out of this, loan repaid, which is highlighted with a star mark, 5,000. Now bank loan is going to be repaid and this is the amount to be deducted or minus as it is paid to the bank. So after minusing this value, we get 30,000. Now just observe my balance sheet, both the side is the same which I get. Just observe it. My balance sheet, both the side is the same. 182,300. So this is just similar to the value given in the question. 182,300 is the balance sheet. So we have done with the complete exercise 2.